Hello, I'm Blake Ress, Commissioner of the Indiana High School Athletic Association. Today, I'd like to tell you about a friend to the more than 160,000 student-athletes in the state of Indiana, Farm Bureau Insurance. In their own low-key way, Farm Bureau Insurance has played a key role in the success of high school athletic programs throughout the state. Since joining the IHSAA as its exclusive corporate partner in 1988, Farm Bureau Insurance has contributed more than $3 million in support of high school student-athletes. On behalf of all the member schools of the IHSAA, we would like to take this opportunity to thank Farm Bureau Insurance for its support of our young people.
As we come back and get set for the opening tip-off, John, let's get to your keys to the game. First off, for the Brownsburg Bulldogs.
For Brownsburg, they've got a pressure defense. Marion can score a lot of different ways. They've got to put a hand in the face on each Marion shooter and let Hayward handle the ball. He controlled the game last week against New Albany, and he needs to control the tempo of this game for Brownsburg.
Let's get to the starting lineups now. First off, for the Bulldogs of Brownsburg, there's that two-headed monster I spoke of, and I say that in all due respect, Gordon Hayward and Julian Mavunga. They got a good supporting cast for Joshua Kendrick, but those two guys are the big guys you're going to have to deal with. Now, before the there's Joshua, his mark in his fourth year at Brownsburg. Now for the starters for the Marion Giants. We'll get to them. There they are. McCallum, Wood, Mays. Mays is the guy they're going to key on the entire game. Jay Edwards and Lamar Jackson. And Joe Luce in his fourth year at the helm of the Marion Giants. We're ready to play basketball. The 4A championship is up for grabs, and the opening tip is controlled by the Brownsburg Bulldogs. And there is nobody left in Brownsburg tonight.
They're all here. They took some of the seats that Harding did not sell and bought those. And they are here in full force.
Ray Tebby with his fifth state championship. Jerry Steiglitz with his second and the first ever for Doug Greenlee. Ray's from New Palestine. Jerry is from Fort Wayne. And Doug is from DeMott. Our congrats to those guys for earning their right to work to this championship game. Brownsburg will be the visiting team. They will wear the purple uniforms. A lot of purple and white on the floor tonight as the first shot is missed and the Giants come off with a rebound.
Now, both school colors are purple, so there is a lot of purple rain here at Conseco Fieldhouse.
Marion 24-4, Brownsburg 21-5. A lot of folks overlook Brownsburg the entire season. Marion, not exactly something that was front page news either. They were ranked very strongly throughout the year. And there's Mays getting things off the snide early on, and the first couple of points of the game belong to the Giants. 2-0 on Mays' bucket right out front.
He has a good drive to the basket. That's how he scores a lot of his points, just like that. Here's Mavunga inside.
And they double, and they triple team him, and somebody got a piece of the body. Joe Luce was wanting a traveling violation and did not get it. There he is right there. Joe, a graduate of Valparaiso University, head coach 2 years at Benton Central, a couple of years at Fountain Central, ninth year overall, winning percentage of 64%, fourth year at the school, winning percentage of 75%. He's done a real nice job at Marion.
How about that? Both these coaches in their fourth year, so these kids are eighth graders when they take the job, these seniors, and they develop into a state championship team. Good job by both coaches.
Here's the baseline shot that's off the mark. That foul was on Lamar Jackson, by the way. First on him. Three-pointer in the corner. Got it. McCallum.
Gerard McCallum, 6'2 junior, averaging 10 a game, makes 40% of his three-point shots. Marion off to an early lead.
Gerard getting the starting call because Javon Freshwater, who normally would start the 5'7 junior, declared out of this game. And so he gets the call and gets the first three-point field goal of the game. 5-0 ball game. Here are the team numbers comparatively.
Scoring, the advantage to Marion at 65 a game. Both of them just under 50 for the shooting. Better three-point shooting team is Marion. as well as free throws, but Brownsburg has the rebound advantage.
And Lamar Jackson that time caught on the inbounds play. Lamar getting personal foul number two. In the first minute and 10 seconds, one of their starters, 6'5 senior Lamar Jackson, with a couple of quick fouls, and that's going to force Joe to go to the bench over there and make the substitution. Caleb Bragg, 6'3 senior.
And that's bigger. 6'5, Lamar Jackson, the tallest player that Marion has that plays inside, and he's on the bench. So that, again, gives Mavunga an advantage inside.
And another whistle and another foul. I believe we're going to get Mays this time.
Mays is guarding Gordon Hayward, and Hayward goes 6'8". Julius Mays is 6'2", so Hayward has a big height advantage on Mays.
Well, I think it's obvious what they're trying to do here already, John. They're saying we got to put pressure on those two guys. We got to physically push them around.
And see if they get some help from their other teammates.
They'll throw it all the way into backcourt now, and Marion will set up on defense in what appears to be, at least initially, a man-to-man defense.
You're right, Bake. Man-to-man defense, and Brownsburg's had trouble offensively getting the shots they want.
Here's Mavunga all the way in, and boom.
Well, that's the kind of shot you want right there. Mavunga faked the three-point shot, which he can make, and found the lane all the way to the basket.
Yeah, if you're new and have not seen, there's a foul going to be called against Blake Hall. If you have not witnessed this Brownsburg team yet, they got a couple of big guys who can really get the job done. This is one of them.
Mavunga takes it in strong. The lane cleared, and he gets Brownsburg's first 2 points.
Mavunga, by the way, is headed toward Miami of Ohio. And the other big fella for Brownsburg, Hayward, is going to go to Butler.
And there's some big names on the Marion Giant team. Jay Edwards, the 6'4 senior, is the son of Jay Edwards, who won three consecutive state championships for the Giants, 85, 86, and 87, with Lyndon Jones. That is his son. And Scott Wood, number 15, is a 6'5 junior. He's on his way to North Carolina State. He'll follow Julius Mays next year. There, Wood, a very good outside shooter, hasn't taken a shot yet today, though.
Well, the word on Jay Edwards, he's going to go to Central Florida Community College. We'll see how that shakes out for him. Got some great bloodlines there, with his father having just a terrific career, his last points out.
Marion has won 8 state champions. They won 7. If they win tonight, it'd be their 8th state championship to tie Muncie Central for the most all time.
Rebound taken off by Marion. They'll hurry to get it back up court and have it knocked away, but last touch by Brownsburg.
I think both these teams are a little nervous, Jerry. This is playing here at Conseco Fieldhouse with a sold-out crowd. Both seem a little edgy right now.
Somehow it just seems right to have Marion back at the state championship. As Ralph pointed out, they've done so much for high school basketball in the state. Bill Green winning 5 championships at Marion High School. Gene Thomas got the first one back in 26, and the last one was in 2000 by Mo Smedley.
Hayward misses on the three-point shot and then commits the foul, going for the steal.
And that's the first on Gordon. Here's a great look at Joshua Kendrick, fourth year at the school, a graduate of Blue River High School and Wabash College. Kind of a quiet guy when you're around him, but a very enthusiastic guy on the sideline when he's coaching. He'll get after you.
He teaches English over at the high school, so works there and coaches there.
Rebound to Brownsburg with 4:15 to go. 7-2, Marion's on top by 5. They had a 5-0 lead at the outset of the game. Austin Fish, another very quiet guy, who one of the keys.
Jay Edwards now draws the assignment on Mavunga. And again, a mismatch. Edwards at 6'4". Was fighting hard inside there. Got some help that time from Scott Wood.
You get the feeling that's about the only way you're going to be able to stop those guys is find the weak side help and send him down there. Substitution now. Gail Watson coming into the lineup for Brownsburg. And very quickly, Joshua Kendrick is not pleased with something he saw out there. We'll get a timeout. 3:54 to go, first quarter, 7-2. Well, Well, we've hit the midway point of the opening quarter of play, and so far the Marion Giants on top by 5-7-2. They get inside. There's Brownsburg, Mavunga, a retucket with 44 Gale Watson with no place to go. And they're going to go right back down to the baseline again, and they'll turn the ball over.
Marion's using their quickness on defense to prevent Brownsburg from scoring inside.
And a little body contact. Foul's going to be on Austin Fish. The first of the game on Austin.
Well, for Marion, they like Julius Mays to handle that ball.
3.5 minutes to go now. 4A finals on the line here at Conseco Fieldhouse. Brownsburg in the deep purple uniforms. And in the white, the Marion Giants. The colors are purple and gold for Marion and purple and white for Brownsburg. Down the lane, out of here. Mavunga gets the block, picked up in the corner. The long shot, no good. Saved by Brownsburg on the far wing. Nowhere to go. J.D. Cosby. Boy, he had a big bucket in that New Albany game last Saturday, Laz. You recall that he had been very quiet in the whole game and thought he knocked one down at the end.
Brownsburg came from behind in that ball game and won it. Austin Fish with a nice open shot on the baseline, but missed it. Brownsburg stuck on two. And over 6 minutes gone this first quarter. Only have one basket, the dunk by Mavunga.
2:40 to go in this first quarter. Oh, what a beautiful move to the baseline.
Jay Edwards has some great talent. He got around Mavunga and controlled that shot. You know, he's behind the backboard. Got his arm back out there and laid it in.
Edwards averaging just a shade under 14 per game. That's the biggest lead of the game with 2:19 to go in the first quarter. 9-2, a 7-point margin. Brownsburg may be feeling some jitters, but they've got enough go power that they can maybe get through a couple of incidents here. There's a good putback that time by Mavunga.
Nice job on the boards. He got it right back up there. That's what I meant about Marion trying to figure out how to stop him inside.
Uncharted territory if you're a Brownsburg fan. Yeah, they were getting every ticket they could possibly get, and as John pointed out, they were going to use some of the Harding tickets when they opted not to sell all of theirs. A minute 35 to go. Jumper from outside. Rebound taken off inside. Hayward comes out of there with it. In a hurry up court, comes over to the near side, and now we got a wide open look by Mavunga. He can shoot that outside shot. Maybe it's not too advisable, but he does anyway. And going hard to the hoop with Gale Watson.
Well, Mavunga can hit that three-point shot. He shoots 49% on the year. Excellent for a big guy. But Gale Watson's one that got fouled. Let's watch Jay Edwards. Takes that ball in, spins around, and just reaches his arm out there for a very tough shot that he made. Hayward misses on the three, but there's Mavunga, big and strong, going right back in there with it.
Caleb Bragg on the personal foul. Some substitutions now. 14, Mitch Jankowski coming into the lineup. And number 30, Torrey Nibbs, who's only a freshman, by the way, coming into the lineup for the Brownsburg Bulldogs. Every free throw made today, Taco Bell donating $10 up to $500 to the IHSAA Centennial Scholarship Award. 9-5, your score. And the Giants in no particular hurry right now. Marion averages 65.5 points a game. Brownsburg 57-6.
Interesting enough, they both give up 50 points a game. So they can both play some good defense.
They have used Edwards a couple of times on that high post. And when they get it in there, there's just no place for it to go. Turn the ball over. Brownsburg now coming back up court in a hurry. They got Hayward open to the bottom of your screen, the left corner down there. Jankowski thought about it for just a split second and then opted not to do so. So apparently they're going to play the final shot of the first quarter. This is Hayward out high. He'll just put the ball on his hip and stand there and wait. 15 seconds to go now in the first quarter of play. A very difficult scoring first quarter for Brownsburg.
High double screen for Hayward. He decides not to take it.
Got a it up a couple of times. Off the miss that time by Nibbs. Put back up the buzzer, and that'll be the end of the first quarter. Low-scoring game. Marion's got to be very pleased right now. They jumped out in front by a score of 5-0, increased the lead to 7. And after 8 minutes of play for the 4A title, 9-5, Marion leads Brownsburg. Yeah, we'll get the first quarter numbers for you here in a second. 9-5 is your score. Julius Mays with 4 of the 9, and Mavunga answered with 4 for Brownsburg.
15% shooting for Brownsburg. Only 1 3-point shot made. The rebounds are even. So a very slow-paced game. And again, Jerry, defense is what dominates these championship games for the most part today. And just 5 first-quarter points for Brownsburg.
Marion was 3 of 9 from the field in that first quarter, 33%. Brownsburg, 2 of 13. So the second quarter is underway. 4-point lead. Marion led by as many as 7 in that opening period. Trying to add 2 more, and they do. Baseline jumper left side, Chris Valerio.
5'11 senior, only scores 1.5 a game. But that's a big 2 points for him there.
Takes the lead back to 11-5 now. Brownsburg getting the pick out high. Now they're trying to work it inside, and as soon as it goes to Mavunga, they come from everywhere. White shirts dropping down, weak side, even the strong side going down to take a look at him.
Boy, that's a big help for Jay Edwards as Scott Wood comes down on the front on the side there to prevent the shot by Mavunga.
Good shot off the pass reception by Jankowski. Well, he was ready at last. As soon as he got that, he was ready to fire.
That's a tough shot. Again, he's at his average. He only scores 2 points a game.
He kind of running the wrong way for that shot, but got it and set it up and knocked it home. On the other end, nothing doing. Mavunga comes out of there with a rebound. We were talking about the agility of the big guys in the Class 3A game. Watch Mavunga run the court, and likewise Gordon Hayward. They can both get the job done. Wide open look right out front by Julius Mays.
Did a nice job to avoid the block by Hayward, and still only had a 5-foot shot.
Giants at 24-4, dropping back defensively now. They lost back-to-back games in the Hall of Fame tournament. This is when they were ranked number 1 of the state, and New Albany knocked them off. And then the consolation game later that night, Edgewood beat them. So this one, they must have felt like things were starting to fall apart, but they came back, did a nice job, and lost 2 of their last 5 games to finish up the season throughout the tournament at 24-4. Jackson moving high to pull off that rebound. Lamar Jackson averages over 7 rebounds a game at 6'5". 13-8 ball game in favor of Marion. Long range streak off the very bottom of the board on the far side.
Well, Scott Wood, normally a great three-point shooter for Marion, 45% on the year. Missed his first try.
Brownsburg with 5 second chance points, 3 second chance points for the Marion Giants. They thought about the 3. Mavunga thought briefly about it likewise. Now he wants some help from Hayward. With a 2-man game between the big guys. Now he's going to take that 3 and knock it down.
He can make that shot, and I like he and Hayward working together because that's both your best scorers. Tough to guard that, even with a switch.
Mavunga, he kind of shot glass at me a week or so ago, and we saw him step up early on in the game and take the 3 outside, but you can tell with the way he strokes it, he can knock that baby down.
Now 2 of 8 for Brownsburg, and it's got him just 2 points down.
13-11, after trailing by 7, and the blocking foul is going to be called against Marion. They're going to nail Lamar Jackson with his 3rd foul.
Let's watch Mavunga on this 3. Hayward gets him the ball. Jay Edwards slips under the pick, and Mavunga has a little set shot there he takes from 3, and now a foul against Marion on the block. So 3 fouls in the first half on Lamar Jackson.
Well, now, Les, I'm not sure. I'm looking at the scoreboard up here. I'm not sure they tagged Lamar Jackson with that foul, but that's who the official was pointing at, so we'll double-check that for you. That should have been his 3rd personal foul. Very quickly, they got Caleb Bragg into the lineup. Nice rebound taken down by Hayward. Marion doing a good job of offsetting some of that height with just pure aggressiveness. Looked like it traveled, apparently not so.
That's some wild action right there. It's been pretty calm. This is Julius Mays. He knocks down J.D. Cosby. And that's, wow, that's out of bounds to Marion.
Yeah. And now what are we going to get? A blocking foul against Brownsburg. Austin Fish is in the area, and Austin will pick up personal foul number two.
There's Jay Edwards. He's very quick, and that foul goes on Fish. Fourth team foul on Brownsburg. Fish comes out.
Still not in a shooting situation. 15th foul on Marion and four on Brownsburg. They miss the gimme inside, and here they come right on the break, the two big guys. One of the things about the big fellas, Laz, they don't slow down your fast break at all. They can run right along with you.
Absolutely.
And this is Mavunga missing. Got it back, goes back up, and misses the shot, draws the foul.
Mavunga's really showing his size and strength on the inside now. Even though he misses the shot, he's right there for the rebound. And he's going to cause problems for Marion all night. Misses that little bunny there, and now another one that draws the foul.
Jay Edwards on the personal foul. Mavunga at the line for the first time. Not a very good free throw shooter at 57%. Now for the Giants. McCallum coming back into the lineup, replacing Villarreal. One out of two. 8 points now for Julian. And the Marion Giants bring it back across the timeline.
A little half-court trap, changing up their defense. And that's Jay Edwards taking the drive all the way in. He is really a good, quick player to the basket.
Second bucket now for Jay. Fourth point of the ball game. 3 minutes, 40 seconds. Three-point ball game. Brownsburg had taken that seven-point deficit, headed down to one. Now it's back up to three again with 3.5 to go here in the first half. Hayward way out high. Off of the corner, bounced inside. Mavunga trying to go to the hoop, and he'll draw the foul.
Marion's got a guy in front and a guy in back, and Mavunga's still tough to guard. Good shot fake there, and there's the foul. That'll go on Edwards from behind.
Number two on him last.
Picked up two real quick. So he tried to swap that shot.
...15-13 basketball game.
You saw the same pattern with Brownsburg last week, Jerry, and fact that they don't play particularly well in that first half, but they hold your opponent with some good defense, and they're not that far out of the game, and then they're able to come back in that second half and defeat the number one New Albany team when they did get their offense going.
Joshua Kendrick greeting his crew, likewise on the other side, but the other coaching staff, and we'll take a break. 3 minutes, 20 seconds remaining in the first half of this ball game. 15-14 score. Marion up by one after leading by seven. Let's introduce Todd Mello.
Thanks, Jerry. During that timeout, Coach Kendrick communicated. He said communication is the key on defense. We got to do a better job of communicating, and we have to be more patient on offense, setting better screens. Back to you, Bakes.
Well, the big guys in the middle now for Brownsburg. Mavunga has done well. He has 6 points in this quarter, 10 of the game. But so far, they've got nothing out of Hayward. How did they get him involved, John?
Well, he's more responsible on the outside right now and hasn't looked to score that much for the jump shot. But I think Brownsburg is doing the right thing. A low-scoring game. They want to get the ball into Mavunga, get Marion in some foul trouble. Marion has just not been able to score. This Brownsburg defense, they've switched it up now. The half-court trap again has not been able to get the shots they want.
Hard drive to the hoop that time from Scott Wood. And the personal foul is going to go against 14, Mitch Jankowski. That'll be number one on Mitch.
Here's the shot, attempted shot, the foul. It's in the act of shooting. Only the 15th foul on Brownsburg, but Wood goes to the line.
Scott Wood is up there. This is a pretty good free throw shooting club, although that would not indicate so. Marion on the season shot 73% to only 65 for Brownsburg.
Well, 85% by Wood. That's only good for second on the team. McCallum shoots 86% from the line.
Second free throw is good. First point of the game for Scott Wood. He averages 16 plus per game, and that just gets him into the score column for the very first time tonight. Final 3 minutes of the first half. Three in the corner, too hard. Rebound Mavunga, and then he lost it out of bounds. And the officials say it belongs to Marion. Mavunga really went ballistic for just a split second. He thought it had been knocked away.
All right, let's watch it from the basket under the camera. The camera under the basket, excuse me.
He may have had a point. Nonetheless, it belongs to Marion. The Giants kick it away at the other end. Now was it touched last by Brownsburg? Apparently so. So Marion maintains control. Good look at Joe Luce.
Two crucial calls right in a row against Brownsburg.
Brownsburg has only a couple of turnovers so far in this game. And likewise, two for Marion. So far, not really outstandingly well played. Ball bouncing and bouncing and bouncing and finally falling in for Mays.
Got the good roll there. And suddenly it's a four-point game.
Brownsburg does a nice job of running their offense and being very patient. Mavunga going really hard to the hoop. You get the sense, John Laskowski, that if Mavunga wants to, he can do that all night long.
Well, nice spin dribble to his right shoulder, and Jay Edwards just, you see how Jay was standing straight up. Got to try to bend those legs and move with the big guy when you're trying to defend him down on the block. So that's another foul on Jay Edwards.
That's three on him. What I'm showing is Edwards with three and Lamar Jackson with three. Jay at 6'4", Lamar at 6'5", so they're using up some big bodies just to try to keep Mavunga away from there. They've not been able to get the job done so far. So we'll get a timeout with 2:12 to go now. First half of play, 18-15 ball game in favor of the Marion Giants for the 4A championship. We're back now at the Conseco Fieldhouse. Gary Baker, John Laskowski, and the rest of our Indiana Cable Network crew. I understand, John, that Jason Willey, who's the sports information director for the High School Athletic Association, is taking the day off, not because he wants to, but he has that bug that has hit everybody and his brother throughout the state. Jason, if you're home watching, we wish you the best, my friend.
Mavunga's been controlling the scoring now for Brownsburg. He's got 11. And I thought he would be a force against this Marion team. The difficulty for Marion now is they've got some guys in foul trouble trying to stop him. Jay Edwards out of the game now, averaging 14 a game, so he can't help them on offense.
It's almost like they have set this up, Joshua Kendrick, and have not made Hayward a part of the offensive game plan, Les.
Well, he's doing some things outside to get Mavunga open. Until Marion figures out how to stop him, they may just keep going to Mavunga.
Chased down in the corner down there by Villarreal. Minute 45 to go now in the first half. 18-16 ball game. Marion leads by a deuce. They've been ahead by seven. They've never trailed. No ties, no lead changes. A minute and a half to go in the half. Probably saw Villarreal kind of looking over to the bench to try to get a feel for what Joe wants him to do. They may just be content to play out the final minute 20 of the first half here. Go to the locker room with something positive on the scoreboard.
Well, it's a zone defense by Brownsburg. They're trying to get Marion to take the outside shot. Nobody in the paint really for Marion, but they're an outside scoring team. They're not looking to score on the block.
Now we're down to 1 minute to go in the first half. They're keeping a very close eye in the middle. They had Mays bust in there just briefly. Here's a drive down the lane and a blocking foul called against Brownsburg. Foul's going to be on Blake Hall. Second on him. For those who may not know the area, Brownsburg is a community just west of Indianapolis. In fact, you don't know when you leave Indy and get there. It's how busy things are on the west side of town.
It looked like Blake Hall was there in plenty of time, but that foul puts Marion at the line.
McCallum got the first one. 85% free throw shooter. 4 points now. He had a 3-point field goal back in the opening quarter. Jirab getting the starting call when Freshwater was not allowed to dress for this game. No specific reason given. Just a disciplinary action. Julian scored the last 8 points for the Bulldogs. Now we're down to 40 seconds.
Looks like Brownsburg will wait for the last shot.
And they're down by three, 19 to 16. J.D. Cosby with the basketball. Cosby's at guard along with Jankowski, who was a 6-foot senior, not one of the starters, but they got him in there now at a crucial moment. 15 seconds to play in the half.
We got Hayward down on the block. He's being guarded by Verrero.
And they turn it over, and it's saved. It's going back into the hands of Brownsburg with five. With four, here's the jumper for the tie. It's off the mark, no good. Mavunga just throws up a prayer. And that's the end of the first half. Not a particularly smooth way to finish the first half. Brownsburg has only four field goals in the entire first half. Two of them are threes, but they did not get the ball to go on the hoop from the field at all with any great efficiency. Let's go back to Todd again. Todd?
Thanks, Bake. We're down here with Coach Lewis. And, Coach, the first quarter you guys started off hot, and then you guys kind of went cold in the late first quarter, early second quarter.
You know, I'm fine with our defensive effort, though, and it's a great job by us to hold them to what it is at 16 points. We'll take that. Offensively, don't worry about our guys. We're going to get some looks, and they're just really, you know, good defensively also, and, you know, the toughest team's going to win in the end.
Some foul trouble right now for your team. Is that a concern for you?
Yeah, of course it is. Yeah, both of our bigs are on the bench. You know, we're just trying to scramble and get it done. I thought we did a good job of patching it up, and hopefully we can make some adjustments at half to, you know, come out so both those guys can play the entire second half.
And what adjustments will you make?
Yeah, you know, we've got some time here, and we'll go in there and talk to them. But I think just a little bit more of our guys staying on the ground. Thought we jumped too much, you know, but really defensively we were excellent. I just thought we got a couple calls where we got in the air and we got displaced, and, you know, maybe we'll get those calls for us in the second half.
Okay, good luck, Coach. Back to you, Bake.
You know, he sounds like a very contented coach right now to be ahead by three at halftime, Les.
He's got the lead, and then we got a half to go.
So we'll take a break ourselves. We're at halftime, the 4A title game, the fourth game of the day here at Conseco. 3-point lead for the Giants. Well, one of the reasons that Brownsburg finds itself down by a triple at halftime can be laid right in the lap of their shooting. They went the last 5 minutes and 19 seconds without a field goal, so they have only 16 points at halftime. Coming up, highlights and stats. Bake and Laz now back at Conseco. We're going to show you some highlights, Laz. And when you go to Brownsburg, it's almost got to be Mavunga because nobody else is doing anything for this ball club right now.
Well, they haven't scored a lot of points. Let's look at the Marion Giants. This is
time he went half of a game without scoring. In fact, three of the starters for Brownsburg did not score. Second half coming up. Conseco Fieldhouse. Laz, I don't even pretend to try to understand what coaches' game plans may or may not be, but I know one thing, they have somehow got to get Hayward into the ball game here.
He is a big part of this Brownsburg team. This low-scoring game, I think, does favor Brownsburg. They held New Albany, the number one team in the state, to 41 points and won by 10. Remember how well they played in the second half, Jerry, when they struggled in that first half. They only had 13 points in the first half against New Albany. It was an 18-13 game.
That was one of Mavunga right away, and it's knocked out of bounds. Hayward took only 5 shots in the first half. However, Mavunga took only 7, but he hit 3 out of the 7, including a 3-point field goal. There he is right there. That's the young man we're speaking of, Gordon Hayward, a 6'8 senior heading toward Butler. He averages 18 a game. He did not score in the first half.
Well, he missed all 5 of his shots, but he hasn't forced any either. I think the key for the Marion Giants is to keep Jay Edwards and Lamar Jackson in the game. They both have 3 fouls. They're both starting here in the second half, and they are huge if they can stay in the game for Marion.
Well, Hayward missed his first attempt there in the second half. Let's kind of get a feel for what happened in the first half. Let's go once again to Todd.
Thanks, Jerry. We're talking to Coach Kendrick, and he was talking about just being too tight. He said, we just need to relax. We've got to hit our shots, take it inside, and make sure we hit our free throws when we've got the opportunity. Back to you.
Mavunga just rips that defensive rebound out of there, gets it down in the corner. The 3 in the corner is good. Now, this is the guy that can start things happening likewise. Austin Fish, one of the starters who did not score in the first half. And a steal. Here's Fish again, and he is going to go to the line after being fouled by McCallum.
Now Brownsburg off to a great start in this third quarter. Fish hits the shot, then he makes the steal. And this game tied now with a chance to take the lead. Brownsburg's first lead of the game.
Austin Fish with 2 shots.
First time it's been tied. Here is Austin Fish. Fish is 60% shooter from the free throw line. He's played in every game that they've had this year, all 26 of them. Brownsburg Bulldogs at 21-5. Boy, missed both of them, but they managed to keep it alive. Mavunga just kind of slaps it back. Now he'll fire the 3 and get it again.
How about that? The big 6'8 guy hits his 3rd 3-point shot of the game.
And that is the first lead change of the game. First time the Brownsburg's been ahead, so they've come out strong. Got a field goal from Austin Fish and a 3-pointer from Mavunga. Oh, nice move down the lane by Mays. He's in double figures now with 10. You're wondering about the name Mavunga. He is from, he's born in Zimbabwe and then moved to Brownsburg just prior to his freshman year in high school. And we talked about it last week, Laz. He said, well, all the big kids play basketball, so I guess I ought to also. Nice chase down on the near side that time by Hayward.
Well, the offensive rebound's really adding up now for Brownsburg.
Hayward looking to move with Mavunga down the right side. Now they want a clear out. And an official's timeout. One of the Brownsburg players lost a shoe down there. That's the reason for the delay.
Here's Hayward. Gets the pass to Fish. He nails that 3-point shot. Remember, he won the sectional for Brownsburg on a buzzer shot. And then Mavunga hits one from the other side. So suddenly Brownsburg is getting on that scoreboard. They've got 6 points already, only 2 minutes into this third quarter. And there's the fourth foul on Lamar Jackson. That's a big one.
4 on him. And 3 on Jay Edwards.
Watch Mavunga inside. Kind of throws a wild shot up, but goes right up for the rebound. Was fouled on that shot, so 2 shots for Julian Mavunga.
5 out of 6 in the free throw line. But Mavunga and Hayward in the Southport Regional were just unbelievable. They played North Central and beat them by 4. They played Carmel, the number 5 team in the state, and beat them by 4. Mavunga total in that in those 2 games, 43 points and 30 rebounds. Hayward in those 2 games totaled 35 points and 30 rebounds.
Rebound foul will go against Brownsburg. fact, Jerry, of the six tournament games that Brownsburg has played, four of them they won by 5 points or less. So they've been in a lot of close games, and they've been able to pull them out. So I think that favors them in a close game like this down the wire.
They've done a nice job defensively. They held North Central to some very poor field goal shooting. It was something like under 30% in that game. But you can't stop shots like that.
Julius Mays knows how to handle that ball as he drives into it.
There's that graphic that Laz was just talking about. Their first trip ever to the Boys State Championship. They've had some really good baseball teams out in the Brownsburg area. They got a super little league program and Babe Ruth League type program out there. And the high school program has been very, very effective.
Right. On the Brownsburg bench, a loose ball. They're trying to get to Mavunga. Good job by Scott Wood. He comes from the weak side, and then it's saved. Some contact right there, but neither player had control.
Block from behind, but maybe some body contact. Hayward came in and cleanly got the ball, but in so doing, apparently, a little body contact. That'll be number two on Gordon.
He's tall enough, especially in the block from behind. You got to wait till the ball leaves his hand a little more. See, he was still in his hand when Hayward tried to make that block. He could have waited till it left his hand and then swatted away.
Julius Mays, as Laz pointed out, headed to North Carolina State. He passed 1,000 career points in the game against Lawrence North back on the 1st of December. They put him in the lineup as a freshman. He became the first sophomore to be named Grant County Player of the Year. Remember his sister, Tamika. She was an Indiana All-Star, now at the University of Toledo. Both free throws good.
Mays is starting to show some senior, good senior play for Marion because none of the other Giants have really scored. Scott Wood still has been quiet as well.
What he making 14 points now for Julius Mays, who came into the game averaging about 18 and a half per. Just inside 5 minutes to go now, third quarter, 2-point lead for Marion. They lost the lead for the first time a couple of minutes ago. J.D. Cosby getting the screen out high. Over to Mavunga, a little one-on-one as he drives the hoop, and they're going to hand-check him going in there. Caleb Bragg could do nothing that time but put a forearm out, try to slow him down, pick up personal foul number two.
Well, Bragg is in because of the foul trouble that Marion has inside with Lamar Jackson, and the quickness of Mavunga draws that foul.
Going right back to Mavungo on the inbounds play. Couldn't get it to go. Tipped it up once. Went back to get it again. Had it stolen away. And they may have Caleb Bragg again. They do. So he has three. Edwards has three. And Jackson has four.
Mavunga's been a key to this game for Brownsburg. They're not scoring a lot of points, but he is creating a lot of trouble on the inside with the fouls that he's created for Marion.
Mavunga now with 16 points and 10 rebounds. Got the double-double already. Seven of those off the offensive glass. The official walking one of the players, Caleb Bragg, over to the bench. And I believe he got a bloody nose out of that, so they'll have to take him down to the locker room and get him, or at least down to the end of the bench, and see if they can get his situation straightened away. There's Caleb.
And there'll be a stop in action, a little trail of blood there as he walked off the floor. And they'll get that cleaned up, so it'll be an extended delay of the game right here.
So while there is that extended delay, we'll take a break of our own. 4:33 to go now, third quarter, two-point ball game. As Laz pointed out, they've got the blood cleaned up. Kevin Horrigan, who's the athletic director at Greenfield Central, volunteers for a number of these tournaments. Kevin was out there doing a yeoman's job, getting things cleaned away. Mavunga misses the second. Or misses the free throw, and now four and a half to go. It's a two-point ball game, still 25-23.
Marion makes a substitution. 52 is Devin Randall, 6'1 junior. Doesn't get a lot of playing time, but because of the foul trouble, he's in there now.
They're approaching the halfway mark of the third quarter. 4A championship, in case you just joined us. The IHSAA sensing body. Here's the first 2 points of the game for Gordon Hayward.
Nice look down the floor as Mavunga got that rebound, and Hayward was out there alone.
So we're tied at 25. That should be the second tie of the game. Last time the game was tied, Brownsburg came right back and took the lead, but not going to happen this time as Jay Edwards answers with his third field goal. He's had a field goal in each quarter, total of 6 points altogether. Capacity crowd or near a capacity crowd on hand tonight. That's the reason the commission was smiling so broadly a while ago. And we're talking with him. Mavunga off balance. Loose ball on the floor, picked up. Giants have it on the run. They had numbers momentarily. Now they put it down to the corner and a reach-in foul from behind on Austin Fish. And now he is in a little bit of trouble with his third foul.
Now Marion wants to run when they can. That's tougher for them to score on the set offense. Let's watch the play here. Mays just stops. Fish runs into him. And that's the foul, number three on Brownsburg. So again, not over the limit.
And with 3:07 to go now in this third quarter, a break. 2-point lead. Marion still hanging tough. Got still a 2-point ball game. Not much scoring going on here in the second half. Marion led at halftime, 19-16. Brownsburg coming out, getting a couple of 3-pointers, one from Austin Fish and one from Mavunga. And then 1 2-point field goal from Gordon Hayward, the first time he has scored in this game. Interesting inbounds play with three of the Marion Giants stacked up the upper corner of your screen. Now here comes the play.
A chance to get Mays and Edwards on a 2-on-2. Brownsburg defended it well.
Less than 3 to go, third quarter. Now will they count the bucket? No indication as of yet. The foul will be a blocking foul. The foul is going to be on Mavunga. That's just number one on him.
Let's watch the play. There's Mavunga. He's moving to his right when the contact's made.
So the fourth team foul against both clubs here with 2:50 to go in this third quarter. Tipped away. Nice play, Mavunga, just to get a hand on it. That's the fourth turnover now for the Marion Giants. So not a lot of turnovers in this game. Long range three. Rattles in, rattles out. Nothing doing. Mavunga's got it. Goes back up. Misses the shot. Draws the foul. Boy, he's been a man among men out there tonight.
Well, that's been the difference. He has carried this Brownsburg team just like Gordon Hayward did last week at the semi-state. Watch him. Gordon Hayward takes the shot from way outside. There's Mavunga. Comes up with it strong. Can't get the rebound basket, but now at the line. And he has struggled from the free throw line, or this would be a much a different situation with Brownsburg in the lead.
He's only hit one out of his last four free throws. And this one finally does fall inside for him. In that win over New Albany last Saturday, Hayward 24 points and 16 rebounds. Mavunga 9 points, 9 rebounds. Hayward in that game played all 32 minutes and had only 2 turnovers. Just an amazing storyline as they beat New Albany by 10, 51-41. A lot of folks thought that New Albany would be the club that would be here battling for this championship tonight. They had a terrific season. 2:10 to go now. Inside, way off the mark, into the hands of Scott Wood, the 6'5 junior. 2:05 to play third quarter, 27-26, 1-point ball game. Marion, the team in white with the lead. And they're in no particular hurry right now. I really thought last this would be a little higher scoring game than this, but it's really low scoring, and neither club showing any inclination to try to kick up the pace any.
No, if the defense has taken over, it's just tough to score for both teams. And the foul situation is adding up for Marion, but the foul shot's not going in for Brownsburg.
No, no. You see Brownsburg from the free throw line is 8-16, and Marion is 6 out of 8. So Brownsburg getting plenty of opportunities. They just can't do anything with it. Traveling violation call. Well, they saw the big wide body of Gale Watson, the 6'4 senior, come flying out there. And a little shuffling of the feet, and the turnover gives the ball back to Brownsburg. Five turnovers now for Marion. And 48 to go in the third quarter.
It's the fifth Marion turnover. Brownsburg only three. That's really kept them in this game for as slow as their offense has been.
This game has not had a lot of pizzazz, to be perfectly honest with you. The fans, which there are almost a capacity crowd here, haven't really gotten into this game yet. Mavunga way off the mark as he may have been hit. Ball comes into the hands of Scott Woods out of the baseline. And at 19, third quarter. Nice spin move inside. It's blocked. Mavunga may have been hit with a personal foul. That's a good move by Julius Mays.
Watch Hayward on the defense here by Mays. He anticipates the spin drill, moves right with him. And I think that's a tough call. Hayward's going to pick that foul up. And Mays is going to go to the line.
Julius, after an 8-point first half, has put six on the board here in the third quarter. This is the front end of that one of the bonus. Into the lineup now for Marion. Second shot good. To play here in this quarter.
Caleb Bragg is back in the lineup, Jerry. He was 25. He had the bloody nose. Must have got some blood on that jersey. He's now wearing number 40.
Okay, that's I was having a little trouble here trying to get this get that straightened away. So that's what they've done. They've changed jerseys. I'm not sure they may have announced it to the crowd, but number 40 will be Caleb Bragg. Well, we're live at Conseco Fieldhouse. Jerry Baker, John Laskowski, and the rest of our Indiana Cable Network crew down to the final 35 seconds of the third quarter. Brownsburg in the purple uniforms, Marion in the white uniforms. Neither club able to shake the other, though early on Marion had a 7-point lead in the first quarter. Now it's a 2-point ball game. The final 15 seconds of this third period. Hayward driving into the hoop, gets the layup, gets the bucket. That's the most aggressive move he's made so far. 5 seconds to go in the quarter. On the floor, reach in foul. Austin Fish, if it's his, it's four.
All right, let's watch Hayward. They're dribbling to his left, but uses size, the 6'8", to take that ball high. Couldn't get blocked. Tied the game, but now 4 seconds to go. Fish commits the foul, his fourth, and now Mays, number 30, Jared McCallum at the line.
So they're going to have to get Fish out of there with that fourth foul, and Mitch Jankowski will come back out onto the floor. Scott Wood is out there likewise for Marion right now, along with Julius Mays. And couple of free throw attempts, first of which is no good. Here's the long baseball pass to the end of the court, and oh my, that would have counted had it gone. Great pass by Mavunga. And that's the end of the third quarter. It was a 3-point ball game at halftime. It is all tied up as we go to the final 8 minutes for the Class 4A IHSAA State Championship game. We're locked at 28. Tie ball game going into the final 8 minutes of this championship game for the 4A title. And let's take a look at the numbers now through three quarters of play. And boy, still the Brownsburg shooting is way off the charts, only 22%.
Amazing. They've tied this game when they're shooting half the percentage that Marion is. They're not getting any more free throws. There is Caleb Bragg. He switched jerseys down number 40 out of the game. Jerry, remember last week at Southport, New Albany led 30-24 at the end of the third quarter. Brownsburg scored 27 points in the fourth quarter to win that game by 10. But very reminiscent of a week ago. Let's see if Brownsburg can get on track offensively.
I remember how we were commenting, my goodness, they're going to score as many in the fourth as they did the first three quarters of that game.
And they did exactly and won that game. Marion, on the other hand, is slowing things down, trying to get the good shots.
Fourth quarter just underway. The 4A championship is on the line. We've crowned three champions already. Mavunga got a piece of that ball that time. I don't think it would have gone anyway. That's the second block shot for Mavunga in the game. Banked off the glass and good by Jamie Cosby.
Nice shot. Mavunga leading some interference with the block there, so the defense couldn't get out to him. And then Cosby hits the shot.
That's the third lead change of the game so far, as the fourth quarter just gets underway in front of a jam-packed crowd here at Conseco Fieldhouse. 30-28 Brownsburg, looking for their first ever state championship in boys basketball. And a quick timeout will be taken, a 30-second timeout by the Marion Giants.
Here's Brownsburg, good lead pass by Hayward. There's the defense that Mavunga used so that Marion couldn't come out and block that shot. Nice bank shot by Cosby.
Playing for their record-tying eighth state championship, 20th finals appearance for the Giants. I just look at here, Labs, the fewest points scored by a Class 4A championship team individually. 50 points by Lawrence North against Columbia City in 2004. They got a long way to go to get the 50 points to spar either club for that matter.
Well, this is a type of game. Remember, we talked about Brownsburg of their six victories here in the tournament. Four of them have been by 5 points or less. They're used to these types of ball games. Marion's had an easier run to get to this final game.
You look back over the years, and they've run the gamut, has Marion, in winning their state championships. They've won it with 30 points, which they did in 1926. And they've won it with as high as 82 points, which they did in 76 when they knocked off Rushville. Now let's see what Brownsburg wants to do. A little cat and mouse game here. They're up by a deuce, one of the few times they've led. Nice backdoor cut by Hayward.
Mavunga again catches the ball at the high post. Hayward on the back cut gets the layup. And the Brownsburg offense come to life in this fourth quarter.
And that's the biggest lead of the game for Brownsburg at 4 points, 32-28 with 6:10 to go. Now we'll see what Marion's got. Can they answer the bell? Working inside, working. Ball will not fall for Julius Mays, but a foul is called.
Now Mays does a nice job to draw that foul. Let's take a look at Brownsburg, though. The pass to Mavunga, the back cut by Hayward, used his body well there. Looked like some contact, but he gets that basket. Hayward picks up the foul, though, at the other end.
That's the fourth foul on Hayward, by the way, Laz.
He's got to be careful because Brownsburg goes as Hayward goes. Julius Mays did a nice job there creating that foul. He got into the lane, and he has given up 6 inches to Hayward, who was able to draw that foul.
But they make, yeah, they're going to take Hayward out of there. Probably somebody saying, well, Laz, what are you talking about? Hayward's only got 6 points. But you're right, it's the way they work, he and Mavunga in tandem. So the actual points don't represent the importance of this guy.
You can't guard both of them. They're too dangerous. It was Hayward's opportunity last Saturday. Mavunga's the one carrying low this Saturday.
One out of two from the line. 16 points now for Julius Mays. 2.5 points shy of his normal scoring average of 18.5 per. He's a 6'2 senior, and we're just 2 minutes into the fourth quarter. 32-29 ball game. Inside, nowhere to go. So they'll take it back outside. Mavunga thought about another three. Changed his mind. He's right in front, of course, of the head coach over there, Joshua Kendrick. He might have been whispering in his ear. Not this time, big guy.
See, the defense can change now on Mavunga. Julius, Lamar Jackson's back in the game, Jerry. He's got four fouls, and he's trying to stop Mavunga.
Well, that's a tough task right there. He's all over him, trying to body him. They'll just back it out and start again now.
They're buying some time with Hayward on the bench. Not a bad strategy for Brownsburg. They've taken 50 seconds now off this possession. and Hayward's gotten to rest and avoid the fifth foul.
Keep an eye open on Fish in that left corner up there at the top of your screen. He can really hit the threes in that particular area. And here's a pick set out high, and it's going to be an offensive foul called against Blake Hall. He set the pick, and I think he moved into the defender as he came by, and he has picked up his third foul.
Tough play there for Brownsburg. Here comes Blake Hall, 34, on the left part of your screen. We don't see it there, but he got screened and called for the foul. Good break for Marion.
3 minutes into the fourth quarter. 32-29, very low-scoring game. Three in and out. Rebound into the hands of Blake Hall. Joe Luce on the far sideline exhorting his ball club to keep right on trucking. And we're going to get a 30-second timeout. Joshua Kendrick says, I want to talk to these guys. And good Lord, there's Luce clear out at the midcourt stripe.
Came out to see Scott Wood. Marion really struggling here in this half. They had 19 points at halftime, and they now have scored 10 points here.
They got three field goals, John. That's all they got this half.
See how quickly it can change. Brownsburg had the trouble first half. Now Marion's having trouble scoring.
They have three field goals, two from Julius Mays, one from Jay Edwards, and then they have hit four out of six from the free throw line. That's it. Second half of the Marion Giants.
So advantage Brownsburg here as they have got this lead by three now. I think Joshua Kendrick called that timeout because if you could get this lead to five or six, that would be a big lead with 4.5 minutes to go in this fourth quarter.
Well, to reset the scene for you, Marion led at the end of the first quarter 9-5. They were up by three at halftime, 19-16. Brownsburg came back to tie, make it 28 all at the end of three. And now in the fourth quarter with the clock showing 4:41 to go, it is a 32-29 ball game. Marion, 2 points, has scored 2 points in the last 7 minutes. They've gone almost a quarter with only 2 points.
Well, and the other reason Joshua Kendrick used that timeout to get Hayward back in the game because he knows he needs him to be effective on offense.
Cosby, skip pass across to the near side. Here's the three, and that's just the guy that I told you about a while ago. Austin Fish, this time he sneaked over to the other side and knocked it down. That was a big bucket for Brownsburg.
And then Brownsburg called timeout right away, probably to get Jankowski in for Hayward on the defensive end so Hayward doesn't pick up that fifth foul. Can't do that a lot. You're going to run out of timeouts.
But didn't we see this with when they were protecting Mavunga last Saturday?
Absolutely. They do it very well. There's the game reset. 19 fouls, so both teams will be shooting the double bonus for their next free throws. Possession arrow favors Brownsburg. They have turned it around again in this fourth quarter, just like they did last week against New Albany.
6-point lead for Brownsburg. Yeah, here's the corrected, this is the score by half right here, 35-29. It's correct something. There's only five team fouls against Marion, nine against Brownsburg, so their stat was a little bit off the mark. 10-2 run for Brownsburg since midway through the third quarter. John pointed out earlier, this is a Brownsburg club that they don't really lull you to sleep, but you got to be careful because they're continually coming at you.
Absolutely. Each possession they take very seriously, and it plays out in the fourth quarter. They kind of wear you down.
Marion doing a good job of getting it inside. It's time to Lamar Jackson, and those are the first 2 points of the game for the 6'5 senior who averages just a touch over three per big bucket.
Well, and now Hayward's still out of the lineup, so Brownsburg trying to figure out how to score. Marion knows they can double-team Mavunga, although Fish was able to hit that three-point shot the last time.
But when Mavunga got it down in the corner, they sent two guys after him. Now they've got single coverage defensively on him. He'll get inside, flip it back outside. Now there is the shot from Fish. This time nothing doing. Rebound, put four. It was caught momentarily into the hands of Blake Hall, but he couldn't hang on.
Good steal. McCallum was there to make that steal.
Blocking foul, the bucket, will they get it? Boy, how this game has turned.
Count the basket. That was Julius Mays on the drive. Watch him now. He's got two Brownsburg players to contend with, and that's a good call. Jankowski wasn't square. The basket counts, and Mays will be at the line.
Julius with 18 points in the game right now. That's right at his scoring average. Well, when the going gets tough, you count on guys like Mays or whomever to step up, and Julius is doing that right now. Gets the roll.
Hayward back in the game for Brownsburg, and now another timeout.
Now it's down to a one-point ball game. Stay with us, Duke. You dare wander off. 3:14 to go for the 4A championship. Conseco Fieldhouse. Matt John has been our producer director today, and we've had a couple of crews in and out of here, and we appreciate their long day likewise. Terry Moore has been handling our stats next door to us, and John and I have been here throughout the day, and glad to have you along. All right, lads, we're down at the final 3:14 in a one-point ball game.
What a way to finish the day, Jerry, with two really heavyweight fighters battling it out. 3 minutes to go. Hayward has four fouls. Lamar Jackson has four. It's going to be a great 3 minutes.
It's a good analogy. It's a heavyweight fight where they just keep slugging each other and nobody goes down. Now we're down to 3 minutes to go on this championship game. Crosby out high. Get Hayward over on the left wing now, right in front of the head coach. Battle inside. Marion player goes down. Mavunga almost went down. High pick. Hayward off of the corner and a foul out high.
That's on Julius Mays, but as you mentioned, Jerry, just a 16 foul now, so out of bounds to Brownsburg.
Well, Joe Lewis has had quite a year. They were preseason ranked number two. They finished tied for eighth. They tied with Newcastle for the conference championship of that North Central Conference, one of the toughest conferences in the state. They were ranked 40th in the state in offense and 18th in the state in average margin. Oh, big bucket right there by Hayward.
On the baseline, a turning jump shot. He's coming to life in this fourth quarter.
He has picked up 8 points after being shut out of the first half. This is a guy that averages 18-1 per game. 2.5 minutes to go. Now every possession, so vital. Oh, what a beautiful move on the baseline by Mays again.
He got around two Bulldogs and then floated one over Mavunga. So Julius Mays and Gordon Hayward are leading their teams trying to win a state championship.
Mays now with 21. 2 minutes, 5 seconds to go now. Fourth and final quarter. Nobody leaving Conseco Fieldhouse. Three-pointer off the mark. Tip free. Fought for. Lamar Jackson comes out of there with it for the Marion Giants, who trail by one.
Nice rebound by Jackson. He's avoiding that fifth foul and doing a nice job inside on Mavunga.
Now the crowd starting to rise as one all the way around Conseco Fieldhouse. And there aren't very many empty seats in this fine facility right now. A minute and a half to go for the 4A title. They've got it in the hands of the guy they want to have. It's Julius Mays. They'll bring Scott Wood out. He'll just make a run through to the far side. I would not be surprised to see a timeout by Joe Luce at any second here. And play for the final shot, perhaps. Oh, a near steal. Penetration inside by McCallum. They got it back outside to Mays. Goes down the lane and gets the teardrop.
No, they're going to call a charge. The inside official called a charge on Julius Mays. Mavunga went down. It didn't look like there was a call. Let's watch Mavunga. He's got position right there. There's the contact. And the official underneath, after the ball goes through, he calls the foul. And that is a big play in this ball game.
As a matter of fact, there was such a delay that I'd already started to write down the bucket. Oh, that is true, John. That is a monster play. The foul is significant only in the fact that it's his third and the time with a minute five to go. But what it does is wipes off the bucket.
Could have been a three-point play because he would have had a free throw coming. Now it's Brownsburg's ball with a one-point lead and 1:05 to go. Wow.
What do they say, John? This is the reason they play the games?
That's why they play the game. Absolutely.
Man. We've had an interesting day just to kind of catch you up on the games throughout the day. Well, we've had some mediocre play, and we've had some terrific play in the Class A game. Triton knocked off Lutheran 50-42 in a very slow-paced game. And then Lures and Winchester took the floor, and they kicked the tempo up by about 120 miles an hour, with Lures winning at 69-67. In the 3A game a while ago, it was, as we thought it might be, just too much Washington for Harding, 84-60, the final. And now, John, we're down to the minute five here.
Big possession. possession, obviously, for Brownsburg. Expect that ball in Gordon Hayward's hands. Marion is going to probably have to foul unless they come up with that steal. That'll put 1-1 for Brownsburg. Hayward is Brownsburg's best free throw shooter at 79%, but they drop off significantly after that. They're only 65% as a team. So this last minute of free throw shooting will determine whether Brownsburg wins the state championship.
And they got here, John, they being Brownsburg, on the back of Julian Mavunga, and he has not scored here in the fourth quarter.
Nobody after Hayward shoots better than 70%, so all the team is in the 60% range, and that's tough for Brownsburg.
Well, Brownsburg right now with the basketball, 1:05 to go. It's one of those games, and I know this is trite, and I hate it people say it, but you don't want to see either team lose this game. They fought so hard. And just when it looked like maybe somebody was ready to put the other one away, back they came from the dead. Marion had a 7-point lead. Brownsburg had a 6-point lead a few minutes ago.
Now full court pressure by Marion. They're trying to create that turnover. And if they can't do that, they're going to have to foul. And that's why Hayward handles the ball for Brownsburg. Same situation we saw in the New Albany-Brownsburg game on Saturday.
And you're saying, what's the big guy doing with the basketball? Well, basically, he can play guard for you. Except how good a ball handler he is. Crosby with it. Crosby trying to find some help. Penetrates inside, goes to Mavunga. 42 seconds to go in the ball game. Wide open look in the corner. Ooh, Crosby thought about it for just a minute.
Now, if they can hold the ball until Marion makes the foul, it's just a matter of who they're going to have foul. Mavunga, not a real good free throw shooter either. Now, Joshua Kendrick calls timeout.
Running a little triangle offense right in front of the Brownsburg bench. And they take the timeout. And there it is. It's all said right there at the top of your screen. 37-36, your score. Brownsburg leads by one with just under 31 seconds to go. Each club with two timeouts left. Brownsburg has committed 10 fouls, so Marion would be in the double bonus. Marion, on the other hand, has committed 7, so Brownsburg would be a 1-plus situation. And last, the question now is, how long can you wait if you're Marion?
Well, this is a little advantage of Marion because Brownsburg has an out-of-bounds play, always a chance to steal the inbounds pass, and Marion can't wait more than 10 seconds. They're going to have to commit a foul, which would give them 20 seconds, depending on what the score is at that point, can determine whether they're going for 2 points or they may need a 3-point shot to try to send this game into overtime.
Well, the upside for Marion is that if you foul and Brownsburg makes both free throws, you're still a one possession situation. Well, we've had a terrific crowd today. Look at this number, John, 18,305.
Well, that's more, as some of these kids will have to play 6 ball games before they can get a crowd like that. That's just great fan support by both teams. And there's the Brownsburg fans who have really bought the most seats of any team in the Final Four in their championship games this week.
Well, you know when you get here for the first game in the morning that if you see folks sitting way up high, you're going to have a great day. And we had them sitting up there, John, and I noticed that early on this morning for that Class A championship game. 18,000 plus. That's just fantastic, and the fans deserve to get themselves a round of applause.
Out of bounds on the side. Brownsburg can use all the court to get the ball in. They're not restricted just to their side of the floor. They look for this ball to go to Hayward as quick as they can.
All right, here we go now. The inbounds passer is Austin Fish. Fish will get it inbounds to Mavunga. Mavunga's got to be careful now. They've got him trapped at the corner. Now they finally get it free, and J.D. Crosby is going to be hit and fouled.
Now, Marion did the right thing. They knew to face guard on Hayward, so he couldn't get the ball up. They fouled Crosby, 63% free throw shooter. Now, here's the play. Great. They could have trapped right there because Mavunga's in a bad position. There you see Jay Edwards coming up to try to trap, and then they do try for the steal, and they couldn't get it, and Crosby at the line.
63% shooter. Crosby has not been to the line yet in this game tonight. He has 1 field goal for 2 points. He averages 6 points per game. His basic job is assist and steal, but this is a big free throw.
The other thing for Brownsburg, they've got their 2 6'8" players. They could tap that missed shot away and to the backcourt and try to get a rebound there, but Cosby was pretty cool on that first one.
This one looks short, is short. Rebound off into the hands of Jay Edwards. 2-point ball game, 38-36, under 20 seconds to go. Here comes Marion.
Let's see if they decide to take timeout or just run this play, depending on the defense that Brownsburg has set.
Well, they're not in any particular hurry, are they? They got it in the hands of Julius Mays. They come off of the near side. They go for three, and they knock it down in Scott Ward. Oh, my goodness. With 1 second to go. 1 second to go. When the ball went in, they had time, I believe, to get the ball in and maybe get some kind of a shot. But instead, they just kind of toss it up there. Let's see if we can. Matt's going to try to give us another look at this whole scenario here. Oh, this is a big, big bucket.
Julius Mays gets it to Scott Wood, a great three-point shooter. 3.2 when that shot goes in. Brownsburg called timeout right away, and the officials are now looking to see how much time is left. But Wood had struggled all game long. How many did he have, Jerry, up to that shot?
That was his first bucket. He had 1 point.
There you go. Here's a guy that's one of the best shooters for the Marion Giants, averaging 16 points a game. And when the game was on the line, he came through. That's why North Carolina State wanted that young man on their team.
Well, I don't know if they call that play or not, Laz. If they did, I'll tell you what, they've got more guts than Dick Tracy.
Well, Julius Mays, they just gave him the ball to create. Marion could have called timeout instead of play. They didn't want the defense to set up. They let Julius Mays handle it. Brownsburg was switching on top to prevent him from going inside, and that left Scott Wood. He knew to stay outside on the perimeter, and if Mays got double teamed, he could be open. Scott Wood just hit the biggest shot of his life.
Well, you're not kidding there. Now they have put 2.1 seconds on the board, and that will give Brownsburg one final look. Now they're down by one. They don't need the three, but obviously with the pure geography of this indicates that's what they're going to have to end up with.
It depends how long their inbounds pass can be. If they get it here in the backcourt, they're going to have to take a three. If they decide to throw a long pass, that will give them a chance. So similar to what Minnesota beat Indiana in the Big Ten tournament on the last second shot.
So they'll start at about three-quarter court, just to our left. Now, it's not Brownsburg, or check it, Marion wants a timeout. Now, it would not be totally inconceivable that they could break somebody free, get the pass to them, and still call a timeout down here with maybe, what, John, a half a second left or something like that?
That'd be tough. You got to give a guy a chance to catch the ball, make a dribble heading toward the basket, and then get a shot away. I look for Hayward to be the guy. He's not taking the ball out of bounds. Look for them to fake up and then try the pass so they're going toward the basket, take one dribble, and let that shot go.
Well, let's see who's their best outside shot. Well, John points out probably Hayward. Look at this thing again. This is just a thing of beauty here.
Woods doesn't take a lot of time. That bucket goes, and then Brownsburg able to call the timeout. And Woods, he follows Mays right down the line, and he's ready to shoot as soon as he gets that ball.
I think you're right on, John. When Mays made the cut inside, the defenders dropped back in there with him, and all you saw in that time was Wood just kind of sliding along with him. He was expecting that pass.
Yeah, smart play. He saw that his defender had left him. You just got to be in a position where you can catch the ball and shoot it. And as Mays moved toward the left, Scott Wood moved toward the left, and give Mays credit for giving that ball up, because he did not have nearly as good a shot as Mays.
And you know everybody and his brother was thinking that Mays was going to be the guy to take the shot. There's a bit of a smile on the face of Scott Wood, and why not? His first field goal today, his 86th three-pointer of the year, and now we're down to the final 2.1.
Good timeout by Luce, the Marion coach, Joe Luce. He saw the way that Brownsburg is set up. Now he can plan a defense unless Brownsburg switches up their out-of-bounds play now. But the 2 seconds with full court to go, not a play you practice a lot in your practice game, because it doesn't come up so rare.
Well, once again, it'll be inbounded just to our left, so they're going to have to go, well, almost 7/8 of the length of the court. Now, that's no big deal. You can get the ball up there. The question is, can you get it to an open man who can get a shot away? Well, they're sending Austin Fish down to be the inbounds trigger guy. Here comes Hayward directly in front of our vantage point. And now Brownsburg's going to take a timeout. They wanted to check the defensive alignment. And now no more timeouts are left for Brownsburg. Still one for Marion. Wow. John, what a game.
It's a long 2.1 seconds.
It is a long 2.1.
Yeah, this is terrific. You're right about both teams not wanting to lose this ball game.
Now, the officials have done a nice job controlling a very chaotic ending to this game, because I thought for just a moment that the game was over after the three-point field goal by Wood. I saw a wild shot taken, but the officials were right on top of it, gave Brownsburg their timeout. 39-38, Marion. This is going to set a record, of course, for the fewest points scored by a winning team in Class 4A. I'm kind of glad I'm working, John, because I don't think I can sit and watch something like that.
Well, it's hard for these kids. Can you imagine trying to be the guy to make the shot? Scott Wood did it for Marion. Let's see what Brownsburg comes up with. I like to get the ball to Hayward somehow and let him take one dribble and let it fly.
Well, I think back to when Luke Sutter hit that shot for Washington back in 05. Everybody had pretty much started their cars to go home, and he knocked one in.
40 feet away. In fact, the same way the Brownsburg's going, I believe, is where he made that shot from.
Well, let's see what happens, fans. Kind of hang with us here. We're down to 2.1 seconds to go. One-point ball game, Marion. Brownsburg will have the ball, and once again, they've got to go about 80 feet or so to get any kind of a shot. Once again, the trigger man's going to be Austin Fish. Odds are really against Brownsburg in this situation. Let's see what they got lined up here.
One more timeout by Marion.
Now we're out of timeout, so we're going to have to play basketball. Well, now, wait a minute. They took a 30, so they may still have a full 60 left if they want to. All right, now we're going to play basketball next time around. This game started out very slowly. Marion led 9-5 at the end of the first quarter. The Giants led by 3, 19-16 at halftime. Brownsburg had tied the ball game at 28 through three quarters of play. That's the last time the game was tied, by the way. Marion is led by 7. Brownsburg is led by 6. That's all irrelevant right now, because just an outstanding three-point shot by Scott Wood has given Marion the lead. And there is Scott Wood, the 6'5 junior.
Austin Fish will be the trigger man for Brownsburg. Hayward's at half court. Look for some kind of screen on Julius Mays to get Hayward open.
Here's the pass up court. Intercepted, briefly put up at the buzzer. Goes in. I do not believe this. The officials. It's over. Hayward has won the game for Brownsburg.
Unbelievable.
John, I don't believe this.
They threw the long pass to Mavunga. He wasn't able to come up with it, but Hayward was there to pick up the loose ball and gets it back in as the horn sounds.
Oh, we're going to look at this baby again and again and again. Here we go.
Good job by Fish, the long pass. Here's Mavunga. Jay Edwards nearly steals it. And there you see, plenty of time left as Hayward makes that shot. There was plenty of time left on the clock. Good angle here. Watch Hayward. He doesn't stop. He keeps running toward the ball. He picks it up, lays it up and in, and Brownsburg wins the state championship.
I do not believe what I just saw.
Very high. Mavunga. Jay Edwards had it. Mavunga stole it. Edwards had it. Mavunga knocked it out of his hands and got the nice roll. And look at the Brownsburg.
Let's go out to the floor now. Todd's got the winning head coach, if he can speak.
We're down here with Coach. What an incredible finish. Did you imagine that for four timeouts?
I came down here with a huge shot, the Wood kid. Both coaches just trying to fill each other out. It came down the end, just kids making plays. You know, I credit Joe Luce and the Marion team. They're gutsy. Those kids have battled all year. I'm so proud of our guys. You know, we didn't shoot the ball real well, but Mavunga carried us. Hayward finished some big shots. That was phenomenal.
The announcers talked about it being a heavyweight fight. Did you feel like that? You're out of breath right now.
Oh, I sure did. I mean, every shot was contested. Every rebound, there was a fight for it. And I'm just so proud. This goes out to all those coaches and young people who got dreams. And these kids right here on my team have written a great story for their lives.
This place is still going crazy. Hayward had a late start. What happened on the floor?
I thought they did a tremendous job of guarding him. They kept him off balance a little bit. Mays did a great job. Mavunga carried us. Fish hit some big throws. I'm just so proud. These kids defended the heck out of the whole Marion to 39 points.
Coach, your first state championship, what's it mean?
It means that everybody that's ever helped me out or helped these kids out have, they're doing something great. And none of us would be here without the kindness and generosity of others. And I'm so proud that people took time to invest in my life, these kids' lives, my coaching staff. It's just great being here.
And the entire town of Brownsburg is here to cheer you on. This place is electric. Back to you, Bate.
Well, I don't know if I could handle this one more time, but Matt John says, Laz, we want to take a look at all three angles one more time. 2.1 seconds remain in the game. You got to go almost full court.
And Fish does the baseball-style pass. Edwards has the ball. Mavunga makes the play of his life. He steals the ball, and then Hayward is right there at 6'8". The advantage that Brownsburg had is they had the taller players. And you throw the ball up, anything can happen. How about Hayward off balance, able to put that ball up, even though he's right in front of the rim. He's able to put that ball up. He gets held right there by Mays, but then has the foresight to continue on, sees the play develop in front of him, lays it in at the horn, and Brownsburg is one happy community.
Well, Laz, I don't know what to say. Honestly, I've been doing this forever, and you never take anything for granted. Let's go out now and pick up the public address announcer. We're going to get the public address announcer for the Trester Award here.
Leadership and athletic ability. In addition to the award, Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance, the proud corporate partner of the IHSAA, will award a $1,000 scholarship to the winner's school. Since 1989, over $590,000 in college scholarships have been presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance to deserving high school students in our state. On behalf of the IHSAA, please join us in saying thank you to Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance for its generous support of our student athletes. After we announce the name of the recipient, we invite his parents to join him on the arena floor. The recipient of this award, while a student in grade 12, was nominated by the principal and coach, excelled in mental attitude, athletic ability, scholarship, and leadership during the 4 years of high school, participated as a state finalist in this sport, and was selected by members of the IHSAA Executive Committee. The winner of the 2008 Arthur L. Trester Mental Attitude Award for Class 4A Boys Basketball is Gordon Hayward of Brownsburg High School.
There's your winner, Gordon Hayward of Brownsburg High.
I'll tell you, Jerry, hits the winning shot and wins the Trester Award. This will be his finest hour as he remembers this day in his future.
And he's headed not too far from here to play his college ball just up on the north side of the city at Butler University. He's a member of the National Honor Society, ranks 11th in his class of 472, a 4.2 GPA. Going to study computer engineering and physics at Butler University. Congrats to him. Well, let us catch our breath and congratulate the Brownsburg Bulldogs on an unbelievable finish to a state championship. Well, as we come back to Conseco Fieldhouse, let's go out and meet the man of the moment, maybe the man of the year as far as Brownsburg is concerned. Todd's got him.
Gordon Hayward is here with me, and congratulations on a great game. And the winning shot, it took you a long time to get going, but when it finally happened, it was miraculous things happened.
It was unbelievable. I don't know how I got open or how I hit that shot. I mean, it just happened. I think that's, I mean, I just have to thank God for everything that's happened this season. It's just, for blessing me and blessing the team, and it's just an unbelievable shot. I don't know what to say.
The announcers talked about it being a heavyweight fight. Did you feel that way?
Yeah, a little bit. I mean, Marion is a great team, and they had some great individual talent. And Julian did a great job. He carried us the whole game, and I just he pretty much just put us on his back and just took us there. And, it was just punches back and forth, and I think it was a really defensive game. But, we somehow came out with the win.
And you thought you were going to win it, then you thought you were going to lose it, and then you won it. I mean, that's crazy.
It really was. I mean, it was a roller coaster in the last, 5 seconds of the game, and I guess it just worked out in our favor.
And you're going to Butler, my alma mater, right down the street. Congratulations on that. And your mom, Gordon, and Jody are right here with your mom and dad.
Yes, they are great role models for me and just taught me everything I knew. I mean, I love them very much.
Awesome. Congratulations. Good luck at Butler.
Well, let's take a look at the Comcast high-speed play of the game. Comcast TV, internet, voice, it's all about options. Gosh, I wonder which play we'll opt to here, John Laskowski.
Probably something in the first quarter,
yeah,
Jerry.
Right.
No, let's go to the end of the ball game. Gordon Hayward hits the shot of his life, a buzzer beater to win the state championship.
I just can't believe this. Comcast high-speed play of the game, one more look at it. Maybe even a third look at it.
Well, don't forget Mavunga. He
yes.
steals the ball from Jay Edwards and gives Gordon Hayward the chance to make that shot.
Well, let's go to the most valuable player of the game. Tonight's MVP is brought to you by TripToCollege.org. Be your child's most valuable parent. Visit TripToCollege.org today for your family's college planning at every age. We're going to choose Mavunga based on what you just said, John Laskowski. If Mavunga doesn't get his hand on the basketball, the game goes the other way.
Well, he also has 17 points, 14 rebounds, as Gordon Hayward mentioned. He carried in the whole game. And then hits this shot from the outside. He was 2 for 4 from outside, made 7 of 12 free throws. He rebounded the ball and really got them in a position where he could make that steal at the end of the game and give Hayward a chance. Watch the hands now. He tapped it away from Edwards. That's the key play of the game right there.
So that's our most valuable player of the game, brought to you by TripToCollege.org. We're going to wrap things up for you in a couple of minutes, but let's take one more break as the final score is 40-39 Brownsburg. Well, if this was a Hollywood script, nobody would buy it because nobody's going to believe what just transpired here at Conseco Fieldhouse. We've got numbers for you. I don't know that they're going to tell you very much in the game, but here's the way the final stats. Not good shooting all night long for Brownsburg.
30%, 13 of 43, and you win the state championship over a team that shoots 47. They did make three more three-point shots. The free throws were even. The rebounding edge to Brownsburg, they did make that into some second-chance points. But, Jerry, it goes back to Decatur Central. Brownsburg wins on a three-point buzzer shot in the sectional championship game by Austin Fish, or this thing never happens.
And Austin Fish is the guy that triggered that inbounds pass. Let's go back out to the floor again. Here's Todd.
Thanks, Jerry. We're down here with Ray Kraft. Ray, you're retiring this year. What a great way to go out.
Hey, we had two right last-second games, and, you know, one kid from Marion seemed to have it in his hands, and it popped out, and they put it in. So, yeah, it's... That's kind of like the Luke Zeller shot about 3 years ago.
54 years ago, your team, Milan, did it. We thought we were going to see a Milan score here.
Well, you know, we almost, yes. The last one hadn't gone in, there would have been almost a Milan score. And the kid that put Marion ahead, that was the only basket he had all night. So, you know, it was a great game.
How do you summarize 25 years with the IHSAA?
Well, it's just a lot of fun working with a lot of great people and, you know, a great staff. You know, the ADs in this state are just tremendous, and they help put on a great athletic program. And, you know, I give a lot of credit to them. It's just been fun working with them and the principals.
Congratulations and good luck in your retirement.
Well, thank you.
Back to you, Bake.
Ray Kraft, an associate commissioner for the High School Athletic Association. Well, we'll take one more break and come back and wrap things up here at Conseco. 40-39, an unbelievable finish. John, just a brief comment about Marion. They handled this defeat with as much aplomb as anybody I've ever seen, because it just had to just tear the guts out of those young men.
Absolutely. You think you've got it won, and then a miracle play happens, and you lose the state championship. Marion just a few seconds away from number 8.
Well, we congratulate all 4 of the state champions today. As Ray pointed out, we had a couple of games going right down to the wire. And this one just epitomized what high school basketball in the great state of Indiana is all about. My goodness. A last-second tip-in bucket by Gordon Hayward, getting him a double-figure scoring with 10 points. Mavunga with 17. Julius Mays had 21. Big three-pointer by Scott Wood appeared to have Marion in the driver's seat. Don't forget the baseball state finals coming up in June. Look forward to seeing you out at Bush Stadium. John, long day. I enjoyed it, my friend.
I sure did, Jerry. What a way to spend the day.
All right. There's your final score. Our congrats to all of our champions here on the Indiana Cable Network.